and welcome to a tour of Rochford Hall, or however it is you pronounce it, and I'm actually not quite sure. This is a house I built quite some time ago, and I based it off a real house called Stoke Rochford Hall, of Rochford Hall, I'm not quite sure. It's spelled R-O-C-H, I think it's Roch. I'm not sure. Anyway, this is the bloody blah hall. And I saw a picture of the original build, and I really, really liked it. It's a very lovely older building, but it was actually a lot bigger than this one. It did not fit a 64 by 64 lot in The Sims, so I obviously had to make quite a few adjustments. But it's still quite similar to the original house. Although, yeah, like I said, it's been adjusted a bit, and I just like it. I don't know what else to say about it. So let's just get started on the tour. In this family lives a family called the Rochfords. I'm just gonna put it on play again for a while. Okay. Let's see. The father is called Baron, the mum is Lisa, and then we have Adam and Vivian, and the twins Naomi and Nina and Liam. So it's a big family, but you know, it's also a very big house, so I figured why not have a big family living in this house? Otherwise it's a bit of a waste of space if there are only a few of them. So you enter the house through here, and then you get into the main entrance. On one side you have sort of like a wardrobe, whatchamacallit, and on the other side you have just a mirror. And from this place you can go either upstairs or to the rooms beyond it, or to one of the sides. So, but let's go this way. Actually, I had a great time creating this lot, because I tried quite a few new things, like this little bit here and also the wardrobe here. So I always enjoy doing things that are maybe a bit different. I keep banging your heads against a wall. Okay, this is the kitchen. It's a rather old-fashioned kind of kitchen, but I think it suits the house really well. There's something smelly behind here. What is that? Oh, hang on. I have to investigate now. What is this? Something behind the counter here that is smelly. Can't be this thing. Oh, I think someone was actually making something and then they never finished it, and it might be just stuck clean up underneath these things here. So I think it's just this cutting board that smells. Might have been sitting there for ages. Okay, so this is just the kitchen. I'll show you the other side of the kitchen. Was there a door there? Oh yes, there's a little door here that goes to another side entrance of the building, and it just has some whatever. Making any sense. Some wardrobe thingies. Lockers. Yes, that's the word I was looking for. Oh, I'm horrible at times. And if you go down here, you actually can go into a basement. But I'll show you that later. Okay, if we go back through the hallway, I'm really trying not to get anyone dizzy. You can go in here and then you'll enter a big dining room. So there's like already a very big table with some chairs in the kitchen. So the family normally has their dinners there, but I can imagine, you know, they are a rich family. So they might occasionally want to entertain other people or friends, and then they might want to have dinner in a very nice posh kind of dining room. Okay, so let's go back this way. Shall I go straight on first? Yeah, why not? If we go straight through here, you'll get into one of my favorite rooms. I'll skip that room for now. This is like a big sunroom. I always, whenever I have space in a house, I love creating sunrooms. I wish I lived in a big house that actually had room for a sunroom, because I just love it. Like an indoor garden, you know. If it's, I live in the Netherlands, and we don't get that many sunny days, so it would be nice to have sort of like a garden inside, you know, just so you could still have the feeling of sitting in a garden and just relaxing, because we don't get enough days in the garden, I think. Okay, so this is just a room where they can do all kinds of things like painting, playing cards and just relaxing. Okay, let's go back off to the side here. We have like a little bar with a foosball table, and I think, yes, also a dart board. Then if we go through here, we get into a lounge. And I actually, in the real house, you have a room similar like this. It's, the colors are all different, but it has just a whole bunch of couches and coffee tables where people can just sit and relax and talk to each other. It sort of looks like a gentleman's club a bit. Actually, that's what I was going for. And, you know, if they want to talk to somebody or entertain people, they can also, you know, light a fire here and just chat without watching television. Actually, they can light several fires in here. Nice. Okay, through here, we have a game room or playroom for the kids. So I used a whole bunch of stuff that came with a kids' room pack, I think. So it has like the puppet, whatchamacallit. It's got this computer thingy right here. Really, I'm horrible with words right today. And of course, a whole bunch of bookcases. If I build a house, especially a bigger one, you'll find lots and lots of bookcases, because I'm a bit of a book nerd. So let's go back out here. And I saw Vivian coming out of the other room. Yes. And then on the sides here, we just have two bathrooms. And I know if you're familiar with my builds, but you'll probably, if you are, then you probably know that I'm a bit of a I like symmetry. I'm a bit of a symmetry nut. I like things to be symmetrical. Otherwise, it kind of drives me nuts. If things are just out of place, that's not a good thing. So, okay, if we go through here, I'll just let Vivian walk out. Hello, Vivian, darling. Did you watch TV? I think she needs to go to the loo. If we go through here, we have like the family lounge room. Oh, they're already in here. The family sitting room. So, you know, this is where they can watch TV and listen to music, read books. I think they can also play chess here. Yes, I've got a chess table in here. And of course, another fireplace. I think actually I built this lot before City Living came out, because it doesn't have a game console, and I normally put game consoles in. So I'm just going to do it now, because I'm pretty sure these guys here, these teens, would enjoy one. So I'm just going to change it. If obviously, it's on the gallery without the game console, but you know, oh sorry, electronics. Now that I'm here anyway, I might as well give them a little treat. They're rich, they can go for the big posh one. Here you go, darlings, enjoy. It's like it's Christmas. Okay. let's see, I think we've covered everything downstairs. Yes. So let's go upstairs. So you follow these steps here, and then you get into a very big landing that leads off to different parts of the house. I think I'll go this way first, because then we can go into the... Oh, look, I did that quite well. That was pretty smooth. If we go in here, I probably won't be able to do it here, because it's see, the bend is a bit more narrow. I'm trying. I'm driving everyone nuts. I'm sorry. You get into, ta-da, master bedroom. This is obviously where the parents sleep. It's just a big room. It actually even has two seating areas, because why not if you have the room? And a little changing room back here. Yeah, basically that's it. Oh, and also a desk without a computer, because I didn't want to put a computer in the parents' bedroom. And, oh, sorry. Across the hall here is the bathroom that the parents would often use. I imagine this would be their bathroom. This house comes with quite a few bathrooms. Oh, and if you go through here, you get into, you have a nice little balcony where you can just sit and relax and enjoy the view. Hang on, I'll have to show you the view, because I love creating views when I have houses. I always imagine that I'm a Sim. Just imagine sitting here in the morning or in the evening, just looking out over the ocean while enjoying a cup of coffee or tea in the evening. Wouldn't that be nice? Or just reading a book. So yeah, I always love creating views in a house. So this is, I think, the best view in this lot. Okay, let's see. Let's go through here. Then we get into Adam's bedroom. And Adam wants to be a DJ, so he has a DJ booth. And because it's a boys' room, I went with lots of brown and blue colors. I'm not quite sure why, but to me, this is a bit boyish. And he has a wonderful feature because he has, there are steps here that lead up to his private bathroom. So yeah, it's actually one of the higher parts of the building. And because his room has got blue, then the accessories here in this bathroom are blue as well. You'll see in a minute that the girls have one as well, the twins, and the accessories in their bathroom are pink. So I'm just going to go right through the wall here, and then we get into a library. So if you've seen my tour of Camelot, you'll know that I love creating libraries, especially in big houses. If I were to ever live in a big house, which of course is never going to happen, I would definitely want a library and a sunroom. I wouldn't really care much about the other rooms, but I would want a library and a sunroom. If you go through here, you can actually go upstairs. Oh, although I would also like a studio. See, and now I'm just being greedy. And here you have like a little studio. And we can see that, what was her name again? Lizzie is working on a wonderful painting. Darling, sorry, what is it going to be? It looks like a cloud with three legs. Oh no, it's blowing. Oh yes, a cloud is blowing wind. Very well, darling. It's very artistic. We'll leave you to it. We are just going to go downstairs. Okay, so from the library, you can go this way and you get into the girls' room. The twins' room. Naomi and Nina, was it? Nina, yeah, I remembered. So this is, they share a room, and these girls love to dance. So they've got a little dance floor in their room with a mirror so they can actually, you know, see what they're doing, and they can make their own little choreographies and make sure that they are in sync and whatnot. And if you go up here, they have like a similar bathroom as Adam has, but then with pink kind of accessories. So that's the girls' bedroom. And of course, we have another girl in this house, Vivian. And Vivian, her room is bang, right across from here. What I tried to do in this house, this room, is I wanted to create like a semi-grown-up kind of room. I mean, Vivian is a teen, and at a certain age, teens think that they're grown-ups. So they want more grown-up kind of rooms, and that's what I tried to do here. So she has like this wall here with the curtain that sort of creates a different kind of little sitting room back here where she can just watch TV without her brothers or sisters bothering her, or where she can just have long phone calls and chats with her friends. I can imagine her doing that. Here we have like a little gym. That's nothing very special. Here we have another bathroom. It has similar colors to Vivian's room, so this is her bathroom. Here we have another one with orange accessories, which is, what's his name again? Sorry, Liam's bathroom. So they all basically have their own bathroom. They're bloody spoiled. So yeah, this is his room, and Liam wants to be an inventor. So he's got lots of, you know, he likes robots, and he likes science. Of course, he's got like a little Einstein statue here, and he's got his little whatchamacallit table there, chemistry set, and of course, you know, lots of scientific kind of looking posters. So yeah, he wants to be a scientist. He's a very smart little boy. Yeah, that's basically it. I think that was this bit. I think that's it. That was quick. Actually, no, we haven't seen the outside yet, so I'll just quickly show you the outside. This is just the top of the house. Outside here, I actually wanted to create like a pond, but I wanted it to be modern and straight because that sort of fits the shape of the house. If I'd done something too frivolous here, I don't think I would have liked it. I don't know. And because I wanted it to look like a pond, I made the water green, but it's actually a pool. See, the kids and whoever can just actually take a swim in here. So, and it's actually funny because this, if you look down on the here in the basement, oh, you'll see that these are just trees, basically, but they kind of look funny this way. I like this, they look like bushes that overhang the water. And but you know, they can just swim right through it, so it doesn't block anything. It works perfectly in the game. Here we have like a barbecue with area with some seatings. Well, here we have a few seatings. Here we have like a little fountain with some with a seating area. I haven't really placed any kids stuff in here, because to be quite honest, I built a lot and I made the family, and I haven't really played that much with them yet. But I'm thinking of letting them make an appearance in one of my Let's Plays, because I really do like him. Oh, I'm completely forgetting about the basement. Hang on. In the kitchen, you have steps that go downstairs, and that leads you into a basement. Here, you have like a little storage room that sort of goes with the kitchen, so you'll have like your wine bottles, you know, your, I don't know, kitchen other supplies, your shoes, your dirty shoes, gardening stuff, and then you can go in this hallway. I always love creating basements with hallways, although this one is quite bare. Normally, I put something more in it. And then you have like this is the electricity of the house, basically, you know, like your generators or whatnot. At least that's what they're supposed to be, fire extinguisher. And then if you go through here, you have like a bang, a science lab. I always love creating like science labs, secret labs somewhere. And then you have steps that go up here, and they come out in. Oh, all right, yes, I completely forgot about that. Into this living room here. So yes, this is basically Rochford Hall, and it probably will make an appearance in one of my Let's Plays, probably My Life as a Ghost, because I like it. So I'm going to put it in another world. I'm actually going to put this lot in. Sorry if you hear something, my dog is playing. Sorry. Oh well, I don't want to tell her to stop because she's having fun, so who cares? I'm actually thinking of placing this in the city, on that park lot. So that there's a big 64 by 64 lot in the city, which is not a park, but I think I'm going to place this here, or maybe not. I'm not quite sure. I might pop it in somewhere, or maybe not. Maybe I'll just leave it. Who knows? Anyway, this is Rochford Hall. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I'll just let these people get on with their lives. We'll get out of their hair, and I hope you will join me again on another tour. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.